Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see the basics of trie data structure and how to make it and the use cases of the trie data structure. So let us get started. A trie looks like a tree. Okay, it is very similar to a tree. So if you draw a binary tree, then this is a very simple full binary tree where this is a root, the root node. So the node which is at the top is the root node. And you have the left subtree, you have the right subtree. In the left subtree, this one is the root, okay. And in the right subtree, this one is the root. And these four are the leaf nodes. So this is a tree data structure. Now how does a trie look like? A trie is very similar to this tree, but instead of these two childs, it can have any number of childs which you define. In this tree, this is a binary tree, so it will have maximum two childs. You can have n-ary tree, okay, where a node can have maximum of n childs. A trie is basically a n-ary tree. You can say it like an n-ary tree, okay. So how does the structure of a trie looks like? So let us define the trie node. In a trie node, we will just write it as struct trie node. And in it, what we need is, we need a character type value, char data. Let's say it's char data. Why do we need this character value? Let's say you want to create a dictionary. Okay, you want to implement a dictionary. You will store words in a dictionary and then you will search for that word. Let us say this is what you want to do. Okay, then at each node, let's say this is a node, you will have a character value. Okay, let's say it's C, and then you will have child pointers. Child pointers pointing to the childs. Okay, child nodes. So in this case, we will have a character char data, because every node will have a character. You will see later on why I am just taking a character. You can also take a string. It all depends on your needs and your implementation, but I am implementing a very simple trie structure which will implement a dictionary. So I will take a char data. Then the next thing which I will take is trie node star child. This will be having a single node will be having 26 number of childs. Why I have taken 26? Because in alphabets, in English alphabets, from A to Z, there will be 26 alphabets, which will be from 0 to 25. Okay. This 0 to 25 is a relative ASCII value. Actually, their ASCII values are different. For small A to small Z, you have from 97 to, I think, 122. But if you subtract A with this A, then your relative value will come out to be 0. Okay, and if you subtract B with A, then your relative value will be 1. So this is why I have taken this child to have 26 values. Okay, now that I have taken these 26 values, I will need a word end value. This will keep count of which of the words are ending at the current position. Okay, so this is a trie structure. Keep that in mind, and let's see a structure. Let us just save some values in a trie, and then we will see how to retrieve those values. But first, let me define how does the structure of a trie node looks like. So this is suppose a node, okay, and since we have declared char data, it will have a character value. Let's say I have stored here A. Now there will also be an integer data which will be word end, and let me write it as we, word end, okay, and let's initialize it to 0 initially. Then what it will have? It will have 26 child pointers. So this will be an array of pointer, and this will be of size 26. So it will start from 0, 1, 2, and it will go on till 25. Okay, these are the child pointers. So suppose I want to store AB in our trie. Suppose A is already stored and this is the root somewhere. Okay, I will explain this in a later video in insertion and search in the next video. Okay, how it's done. But here I will just simply explain the logic behind it. Suppose A has already been stored and now you are storing B. A is stored. So in order to go to B, you will take this first pointer and you will make another a trie node which will have a value B. It will have word end equals to 1 because the word is ending here, and then you will have again 26 pointers, and all these values will be pointing to null value, because this is the leaf node, okay? And in this node, this A node, we have 25 values as null, and this value is only pointing to this node B, okay? So this is how a structure looks like. Now, what is a root node? Let me explain you the root node. A root node is the same node, but here you don't have any value for character. You will not assign any value to the root node, but it will have these 26 pointers as you have in your normal nodes. You can see that in A node, you have a character value, you have a word end value, and you also have 26 pointers. But in a root node, you will not have the character value. You will not have the word end value. Word end value will always be 0. Okay. But you will have all these pointers. These 26 pointers will be present. Okay. So this is it about the root node. So let us just implement a dictionary. Let us store some values in a dictionary and then we will just search for it. So before making anything, when you are implementing a trie, the first thing you should remember is the root node is always present. So in your init function, in your initialization, during making your trie, you should first initialize the root node. You should first create the root node. Okay. So suppose this is the root node. This is the root node. It won't have any character value and it won't have any word end value. Now it will have the 26 child pointers, as I said. Okay. So this will be till 25. 0, 1, 2, 3, 2, 25. Now let's say I want to store these values. A, B, A, A, C, C, B, A, B, B, C, A. Okay. I will just show you quickly. I will not go into the details. The detail part will be present in another video. Okay. So let's say I want to store A, B, A. Now from here, I will go to A. I will make a node A. I will initialize word end equals to 0. Now I will go to B. From here, I will go to B. I will initialize word end equals to 0. From here, I will go again to A. Again to A, word end equals to 1, since the word has ended here. So I have inserted this ABA. Now I'll insert ACC. From the root, I see that the child of root A is already present, so I will not do anything. I will just reach this A. From A, you can see that there is no child named C. So I will create a child named C. From C, I will see that there is no child named C. So I will create another child named C, because you had the word ACC. So now this has been inserted in the trie, and the last one will have word end equals to 1. This C will have word end equals to 0. Now I will insert this BAB. From the root, you can see that there is no B. So I'll just create another node B, initialize word end equals to 0. I'll reach to A. I'll insert A, initialize word end equals to 0. I'll reach to B. I'll insert B, will initialize word end equals to 1, because this was the last node in this string BAB. Now I'll insert this BCA. From root, you will start and you will see that B child is already present, so you will go to B. From B, you can see that there is no C, there is only A. So I'll create another child named C. Okay. And then this will have word end equals to 0 because this C is not the last node. Then I will go to A. I will insert here A. This will have word end equals to 1. Now let's say you want to search the values. Since you have built this dictionary, okay, you can always update the dictionary anytime you like. You can always insert new words and you can delete these words. I will make videos separately for them. Okay. So let's search for BAB. Now that you want to search for BAB, let's see how to do it. From the root, you will start and you can see that B is present. You will go to B. From B, you will go to A. From A, you will go to B, and there you will stop, since the string is BAB. Now you can see that word end equals to 1. This says that BAB is a string which is present in the dictionary, and therefore you will return true, that the word has been found. Okay. Let's search for another word. Let's search for ACB. You will start from root. Always you need to start from root. Okay. You will start from root, you will see A. A is present. From A, you will go to C. C is present. From C, you will go to B. But you can see that there is no child of C named B. Therefore, this is not found, and therefore you will return false. Next, let us search for BABA. BABA. From root, you will go to B. B is present. From B, you will go to A. A is present. From A, you will go to B. B is present. But from B, you need this last A. But B is a leaf node. There is no child of B. Therefore, BABA is not present and you will return false. Next, let us search for BC. Just search for BC. From root, you will go to B. From B, you will go to C. From C, you have other childs, but you want to search only for BC. Therefore, you will check for word end. Here, word end equals to 0 denotes that there is no such string entered in the trie named BC. Therefore, word end was 0, and so you will return false. This will be covered in later videos in details. Okay. So this is all about the basics of trie. Now let us see some of the uses of trie data structure. The first use is that it can be used in dictionary. It can be used to implement dictionary. You can store words, you can store words, you can search for it, and you can also remove words from the dictionary. Okay, these all things are very efficiently done by using a trie. The second thing is that you can just search for a word, that means this search for a word in just order of word length time. Okay, since you are flowing through all the nodes, and therefore it will be done in just order of word length time in order to find whether this word is present in the trie or not. Okay. The third thing is that it is very good in finding prefixes, prefix strings. Okay. I will make another video on prefix strings and how to find the number of strings with the given prefix in one of my video later on. Okay. The fourth thing is that this you might know that it is a very ordered, structured and clean data structure. It looks very clean. Initially you might find it difficult, but when you get practice on trie, you will find it very easy to implement and it is very handful. Okay. So this is all about the basics of trie. I hope you were able to understand the basics, and if you have any type of doubt, then please comment below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.